Greetings. Welcome to ZGC, Zion Gate Chapel. I am Kip Ezekiel, broadcasting from capital city Addis Ababa, on the side of the east, the holy mountains of Ejersagoro, where this man was born, Rastafari. Welcome to the chapel. Today we are going to be covering Revelation chapter 5, which features the seven seals coronation. The book of Revelation, which is written by John, is a book which carries the most symbolic and enigmatic features. It's a book of mystery, which carries messages of the end of things as we know it, and the beginning of a new era. Today we will be covering chapter 5, verses 1 to 10.
Revelation 5, verses 1 to 10. And I saw in the right hand of him that sat on the throne a book written within, and on the backside sealed with seven seals. And I saw a strong angel proclaiming with a loud voice, "Who is worthy to open the book and to loose the seals thereof?" And no man in heaven nor in earth, neither under the earth, was able to open the book, neither to look thereon. And I wept much, because no man was found worthy to open and to read the book, neither to look thereon. And one of the elders saith unto me, "Weep not, behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, hath prevailed to open the book, and to loose the seven seals thereof." And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne, and of the four beasts, and in the midst of the elders, stood a lamb, as it had been slain, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God sent forth into all the earth. And he came and took the book out of the right hand of him, and sat upon the throne. And when he had taken the book, the four beasts and 24 elders fell down before the lamb, having every one of them harps and golden veils full of odors, which are the prayers of saints. And they sung a new song, saying, "Thou art worthy to take the book, and to open the seals thereof. For thou wast slain, and hast redeemed us to God by thy blood out of every kindred, and tongue, and people, and nation. And hast made us unto our God kings and priests, and we shall reign on the earth."
So here, John's message comes down to us in the form of a book, and we must remember that these writings of John are coded and symbolic messages meant for future reference. And in this description of John, the seven seals are found at the backside of the book, which is the Bible. Now that John has sent us in the book, he instructs us to go to the backside of the book, for he says, "Written within and on the backside." So we must now turn the pages and go to the backside, or to the end of the book. And what do we find at the backside of the Bible? The book of Revelation. And in it, what do we have? Seven seals. Now we can understand that it is not literal seals on the back of a scroll. They are spiritual seals which will be opened by Christ, the King. Now in verse 2, the question is asked, who is worthy to open the book and to loosen the seven seals? The elder goes on to say, the Lion of Judah has prevailed to open the book. But John looked and saw the Lamb, who took the book and loosened the seals. Now our question is, why did the Lamb do this? Because the elder said that the Lion of Judah has been found worthy to do this. The answer is, because the Lamb is the one who sent the vision to John. Therefore, he is the only one who can reveal this mystery to John. Now in Revelation 6 verses 1 to 2, when the Lamb opens the first seal, what do we see? Let us listen to the reading.
Revelation 6 verses 1 and 2. And I saw when the Lamb opened one of the seals, and I heard, as it were, the noise of thunder, one of the four beasts saying, "Come and see." And I saw, and behold, a white horse. He that sat on him had a bow, and a crown was given unto him, and he went forth conquering and to conquer.
We can see a king being crowned, and he went forth conquering and to conquer. This is a coronation scene, which features the one who is worthy to walk the walk of Christ. And the prophetic announcement of Matthew 23 verse 39, which was told to us by Christ, saying that we will see him at this specific time when this announcement is to be made. Let us listen to Matthew 23, 39, and also a video clip.
Matthew 23, verse 39. For I say unto you, ye shall not see me henceforth, till ye shall say, Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna! Blessed be the King of Israel. Blessed is he who cometh in the name of the Lord.
Accurate timing. We have here the coronation of the Lion of Judah. The announcement, Blessed is he who cometh in the name of the Lord. And the presence of the Lamb. All these adds up to the other Comforter, the one who will be sent to us by the Lamb. This is found in the book of John, chapter 14, verses 6 to 17.
John 14, verses 16 and 17. And I will pray to the Father, and he shall give you another Comforter, that he may abide with you forever. Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him. But ye know him, for he dwelleth with you, and shall be in you.
This is confirmation. Now at this coronation, the Spirit of Jah will be incarnated from the humble Lamb of God into the personality of the conquering Lion of Judah. And these are two anointed ones which stand beside the God of the whole earth. This can be clarified in Zechariah 4:14.
Zechariah 4, verse 14. Then said he, These are the two anointed ones that stand by the Lord of the whole earth.
This here confirms that there are two persons standing with him in the earth, and they are anointed. This means that they are definitely persons. And to stand beside him means they are together as one with him. Therefore, the Lamb, the Lion, and the one on the throne are one and the same in spirit. So the mystery of the incarnated Jah can only be revealed by one of the two who stands by Jah. So the Lamb's presence here, obviously, is to reveal to us the one who is worthy, the Lion of Judah, who will be crowned upon the throne of David. Now let us look at the other reasons for the presence of the Lamb in this prophecy. One is to confirm the legitimacy of the coronation and also to reveal the mystery of its procedures. And lastly, to usher in the promised royal priesthood of Exodus 19, verses 5 and 6. Now for the mystery and legitimacy. The seven eyes and seven horns of the Lamb represents, as it says, the seven spirits of God sent forth in the earth, and they are reflecting two different images. The first one is the eyes, which are representing spiritual, and the other is the horns, which are representing physical. Let us take a reference here from Romans 1:20, which is about spiritual and physical.
Romans 1, verse 20. For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse.
So by the manifested things we will gain overstanding on the things of Jah. So here we have the Lamb reflecting visible and invisible. The eyes are representing the spiritual side, which is invisible. And the horns are representing the physical side, the things that can be seen, visible. So these seven spirits must have their seven manifested physical or visible side. Therefore, we will need for the physical seven persons to represent one spiritual unit. So for seven eyes, we will need an equivalent of 49 persons, 7 times 7. And these 49 persons will reveal the hidden spiritual things of this enigmatic message. Now let us listen to what was being made manifested at the coronation of His Imperial Majesty, the Lion of Judah. Let us also check the report of the coverage from National Geography on the coronation.
The coronation of His Imperial Majesty Haile Selassie on the 2nd of November 1930, taken from the National Geographic as recited from the website derekbishton.com. For 5 hours, then we witnessed the unfolding of the ancient and traditional Hebraic Christian ceremony of the crowning of a ruler of the Empire of Ethiopia. 49 bishops and priests of this ancient Christian country, in groups of 7, have held place for 7 days and nights in the 7 corners of this national cathedral to chant without ceasing 9 Psalms of David. They are now joined by hundreds more. The thrilling but solemn and silence gently breaks to the throaty voice of His Holiness, the Abuna Kirlos. Ye princes and ministers, ye nobles and chiefs of the army, ye soldiers and people of Ethiopia, and ye doctors and chiefs of the clergy, ye professors and priests, look ye upon our Emperor Haile Selassie I, descended from the dynasty of Menelik I, who was born of Solomon and the Queen of Sheba, a dynasty perpetuated without interruption from that time to King Haile Selassie and to our times. በስመ ስላሴ
This coronation ritual, which features 7 groups of 7 priests in 7 corners of the church for 7 days and 7 nights, are the direct manifestation of the 7 horns of the Lamb, which is the physical side of the 7 eyes of the Lamb, for their works are one and the same. The 7 spirits goes out throughout the world to announce the arrival of Christ in His kingly character. And the 7 units of 7 priests are also sending out the praises of the arrival of the King of Kings, the King of Israel, the elect of Jah, the conquering Lion of Judah. So the Lamb's message here has been revealed both spiritually and physically through this coronation procedure, the mystery of 7 times 7. Let us now listen to Deuteronomy 29:29.
Deuteronomy 29, verse 29. The secret things belong unto the Lord our God, but those things which are revealed belong unto us and from our children forever, that we may do all the words of this law.
Blessed. Now let us revisit verse 10.
Revelation 5, verse 10. And hast made us unto our God kings and priests, and we shall reign on the earth.
It says, has made us unto our God kings and priests, and we shall reign on the earth. Here we have the making of a priesthood. Christ the Lamb has revealed to these redeemed the coronation of the conquering line of Judah, and has ushered in the promised royal priesthood of Exodus 19 verses 5 and 6.
Exodus 19 verses 5 and 6. Now therefore, if ye will obey my voice indeed, and keep my covenant, then ye shall be a peculiar treasure unto me above all people, for all the earth is mine. And ye shall be unto me a kingdom of priests, and an holy nation. These are the words which thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel.
With this new reality of the crowning of the King of Kings, the redeemed has realized their new status and gives honor and glory to the Lamb, for he has now raised their consciousness to the high level of priesthood. This newly found heights of the redeemed also coincides with the call of the returnees of Isaiah 43, who is also called to give praises to the King in Zion.
Isaiah 43 verses 6 and 7. I will say to the north, give up, and to the south, keep not back. Bring my sons from far, and my daughters from the ends of the earth, even everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. I have formed him, yea, I have made him. This people have I formed for myself, they shall shew forth my praise.
Now with this calling and the new identity of priesthood, a new name is necessary. Now according to Revelation 3:12, the Lamb tells us of this new name and identity for the overcomers and Christ in his kingly character. Let us hear Revelation 3:12.
Revelation 3 verse 12. Him that overcometh will I make a pillar in the temple of my God, and he shall go no more out. And I will write upon him the name of my God, and the name of the city of my God, which is New Jerusalem, which cometh down out of heaven from my God, and I will write upon him my new name.
This is the new reality, especially for the redeemed, the overcomers, and the one who has returned. And his new name was revealed to us at the coronation. Kadamawi Haile Selassie, meaning first power of the Holy Trinity. We will reference here Revelation 19:13, which says, his name shall be called the Word of God. Haile Ai, Selassie Ai. Our eyes have seen the King in his glory, and we have heard his words. And for those of us who follows the things that the mythical Lamb has revealed to us, we now have overstanding of the coronation, the marriage supper of the Lion of Judah. For the testimony of the Lamb is the spirit of prophecy. Give thanks. Hope it has been informative, and hope to see you next time in the chapel when we will be covering part 2 of the Seven Seals coronation, which will be featuring the 7 prescribed psalms of the coronation liturgy. Rastafari, blessed love.
Blessed love.